whenever you're ready, Nolan.
Okay. Einstein said, you have to learn the rules of the game and then play better than anyone else. I see this problem in a lot of things, especially in a game like Magic the Gathering. Magic is a fun and exciting way to meet new people and test your own mind. I've been playing Magic for around 5 years and constantly learning and researching new ways to improve my game. Today I'll start by explaining some basic information about the game, and then some commander deck tech, and then other benefits that come with playing the game. So first, I'm going to go over the color wheel. Every card that is in Magic that has a color fits onto this color wheel. So I'm going to explain what the ideologies of each color is. So I'm going to start here with green. Green is the color of instinct and nature. Their philosophy is like a survival of the fittest. The next color here, clockwise, is white. Their philosophy is morality, order, justice. They really like to be fair to everyone. Next color here is blue. Blue is the color of logic, technology, and reason. Because of this, they like to, during the game, they like to be a very slow color, real calculated. Next color here is black. Black is the color of immorality and selfishness. They're really hungry and lustful for more power, even if that means to push other ones that are close to them away. Next color here is red. Red is the color of chaos and being very impulsive and just acting very quickly. Next, I'm going to go over the actual types of cards in the game. So we're going to start here with land cards. Land cards are the most basic type of cards in the game and provide mana or fuel to actually cast your spells. So I'm going to take the mana that I have for this deck and begin putting it together. Next type of card is a creature card. Once you cast these, you cast them, this is how much they cost. Use that mana that we just talked about to play them. These numbers right here on the bottom show how strong they are. And these words here in the middle are usually just extra abilities that come with the creature. So put those in. Next type of card is an enchantment card. Enchantments are like creatures, as in they stand on the battlefield when you play them, but they don't attack any other players. They usually just typically just give you an additional ability. So I'm going to take the enchantments I have for this and put those in. The next type of card is an artifact card. These are pretty much similar to enchantment cards, but they're not aligned with the color. So they're typically objects like scepters, amulets, charms, things like that. So I'm going to take the artifacts I have from that and put those in. Next type of card is a little bit different than the ones we've already discussed. Instant spells and sorcery spells. Once you cast these don't stay on the battlefield. They're gone. They get a one-time use. And the only difference between instant spells and sorcery spells, the instant spells, you can play them at any time. The sorcery spells, you can only play it during your turn. So I'm going to take all my instant sorcery spells. Stick those in there. Finally, the last type of card is a planeswalker card. Planeswalkers, once you play them, they stay on the battlefield, but it's like you're controlling an actual player, a person. They can be attacked, and what they do is each turn they're able to choose one of these abilities here, depending on how loyal they are to you. Now that we've discussed what actually some of the cards are, now we can actually discuss what Commander is and the stipulations for Commander decks. So Commander, your Commander does not sit inside a deck. He sits outside, and he's the basis of your deck. So one of the main stipulations he has to be a legendary creature, and that every card that is in your deck has to fit underneath his colors. So for this example, for Sir the Enchanter, all the cards in your deck would have to be white, blue, or black. And for another example, for this deck, Omnath is a red and green creature. So all my cards in there are red, green, or colorless. now to some extra benefits that come with playing strategic mind games like these. Games like Magic can increase your memory, decision-making, calculating skills, etc. They're really good for helping you increase these. And other than me just saying this, many doctors, including Dr. Gwen Duar, have studied and spent a lot of time researching games like this, and have proven that these do actually help those. Today, I've shown you the basics of the game, some actual commander deck building, and the benefits that come with playing games like these. Now you have all the information needed to begin your journey to becoming a seasoned Magic the Gathering player. Thank you for your time.